Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss chapter 2, that is latitudes and longitudes. Now see, chapter 2, latitudes and longitudes. First, you see, I have written few topics. Whatever I have written here, you just note down and very carefully do it, because here I have mentioned topics. So these topics today I will explain. And homework. What homework you have to do from here? Define the following terms. So that means you have to define. All? No. I have mentioned here tick mark one. Only tick mark, because everything if I give you as a homework, not possible for you to write. So few things I have given, only tick mark one. So 1 to 13 I have mentioned. One by one I am telling. You write down and put the tick mark also. And somewhere I have given circle also. I will explain why I have given that one. You just follow me. Number 1. Parallels of latitude. In short, lat. You have to define it. Tick mark given. 2. Important latitudes. 3. Latitude and heat zones. Here I didn't give tick mark. You please notice. Number 4. Equator. Number 5. Meridians of longitudes. In short, long. Number 6. Prime meridian. Number 7. Local time. Number 8. Find out local time of any place. 10. Standard time. But see, after 8 I have written 10. Then where is 9? 9 I have written last. So after 8, again, once again I repeat, number 9, that is geographic grid. Here also tick mark given. That means it is your homework. Now 10, that one also your homework. Standard time. 11. Indian standard time, or in short IST. 12. Greenwich mean time, in short GMT. And 13. Time zones. So total 13 here I have given, and out of 13 few I have marked. Marked one you will write, you will define them, and all I will explain. Except these two circles. Why? Because these two circles, these two topics will be discussed after opening the school. So you also put the circle. Number 8 and number 13 I will discuss after reopening our school. Now, after 13, 14. 14, there are three parts, A, B, C. A, international deadline, in short IDL. B, need or importance of IDL. And the last, IDL is not a straight line. Why? Then I have given one big circle. Means this total portion, means topic number 14, I will discuss after reopening our school. Now 15, that is the great circle. This one definitely I will discuss, I said, and 16 also. But you just notice, 15 here I have given tick mark, means it is your homework also. The great circle. And 16, importance of the great circle. This one also I will discuss. Only number 14, keep in your mind, only circle portion I will discuss later. Except all I will discuss now. And tick mark one, only your homework. You have to define them. Only except this part, few more homework I have given here. Diagrams. I have given two diagrams. Important parallels of latitudes. And the second diagram, latitudes and heat zones. Very neat and clean way you have to draw these two diagrams in your copy with proper leveling. And few differences I have given. Total 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 very clear. Lat and long. In a short I have written latitudes and longitudes. Second, equator and prime meridian. Number 3, local time and standard time. And number 4, I have written short form. IST and GMT means what? Indian Standard Time and Greenwich Mean Time. That's it. Now students, I think all of you have written all the topics with their numbers. Now I am going to discuss topic 1, 2, 3 and 4 together. You know what actually you have in under these 4 numbers. Topic 1, it was about latitudes. All of you have little idea about the latitudes. All of you know latitudes means some horizontal line. Correct? Our earth, this earth is divided by one latitude that is called equator. But except this line, few more lines, parallel lines are also present above this equator, below this equator. You know about it. And all lines are together called latitudes. And all are full circle. All are full circle. We can see only the front part. But all are full circle. And they are parallel to each other. Now the question, how many lines are present? One is equator. And except above the equator, which is called northern hemisphere, we have 90 lines. Means 90 latitudes. And below this equator, again 90 lines. So altogether, our total latitude number 181. So it is very clear explanation about latitude. Horizontal lines, they are full circle, imaginary lines, moving parallelly, total number 181. But when you will define it, you have to write something different way. What you will say? That all latitudes or the lines of latitudes are imaginary lines which join all the places having the same angular distance from north or south of the equator. Means, suppose if it is one latitude, 30 degree north latitude, suppose it join many places from here to here. So all places have same angular distance from equator, and that is 30 degree. That is the meaning of this latitude. So definition you have to write clearly, but only for explanation, your basic ideas, you have that idea that latitudes are imaginary lines, they are horizontal lines, they are moving parallelly, they are full circle, total 181 latitudes we have. Out of this number, there are 5 important latitudes we have. One is, that one also you have learned, equator. Another is Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north. Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degree south. Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree north. And Antarctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree south. These 5 are very important. This, on the basis of these 5 latitudes, we are getting our heat zones on earth. Done. So these are the 5 latitudes. On the basis of these 5 latitudes, we are getting heat zones. So important latitude, topic 2, there was one question may come. What are the, name the important latitudes on the earth surface, on the earth. So you will mention these 5 names. And on what is the importance? On the basis of these lines, on the basis of these latitudes, we are getting heat zones on our earth. Done. Out of these 5, the most important one is equator. What is equator?
Equator is an imaginary line which divides our earth into two equal halves. Upper part of the equator is called northern hemisphere and the lower one is called southern hemisphere. Now I am going to say about the heat zones, how we are getting heat zones on the basis of these five lines. Now see, this is our earth. It is divided by equator. One line I have done. Now, Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn, 23 and half degree south. So, Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, this area is called torrid zone, means the hottest zone. This area gets direct sun rays almost throughout the year, the hottest area. After that, we are getting 66 and half degree north and 66 and half degree south, meaning name I have already mentioned. So from here to here, this zone is called temperate zone, means it is neither too hot nor too cold. Temperature is here moderate. And from Arctic Circle to Pole, we are getting another heat zone. That is called frigid zone. Means very, very cold. Here temperature almost below 0 degree. Because this area gets very less sun rays. That is called frigid zone. So finally, if we talk about the heat zones, how many heat zones we have? We have three heat zones. Number one, torrid. Number two, temperate. And number three, frigid. Torrid means very hot. That is from Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, because gets vertical sun rays almost throughout the year. Temperate means moderate, neither too hot nor too cold. Location, Tropic of Cancer to Arctic Circle, Tropic of Capricorn to Antarctic Circle. And the last, frigid zone. That is from Arctic Circle to North Pole, Antarctic Circle from South Pole. Clear? Now, last thing I want to say, this area means torrid zone. It's a vast area out of these two. Out of these three, torrid one is the vast one. So, very minutely we can divide this area like this way. 5 degree south. Actually, this area is called equatorial area. And 5 to Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, it is called tropical area. Together, it is called torrid. But torrid one is very vast area, so we can divide it according to the based on temperature and rainfall quantity. We are getting equatorial area and tropical area. But if question comes, how many heat zones we have? Always we will mention these three names and their location. And their location, once again for you, I am writing torrid, that is Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn. This one here to here, and the last one and the meaning of each number I have, name of the each number I have already mentioned. I am going to discuss topic 5, 6, 7 and 9. 8 I said already. In school I will do that part. So 5, 6, 7, 9. Now, meridians of longitude, topic 5. What is the meaning of that word? Longitude, I think all of you know longitude means vertical line. Just opposite of latitudes. Okay. But the difference is all are imaginary lines. All are imaginary lines. But these are half circle. Latitudes are full circle. Longitudes are half circle. That is the main difference. And one more difference. Latitudes number wise it is 181. Here longitude number, total number 360. Okay. Now, latitudes, especially the equator, divides our earth into two equal halves. But here, that type of line we are not getting because all are half circle and half circle cannot divide our earth into two equal halves. But one line, that is the 0 degree one, which is called prime meridian. It is also half circle. These lines, all longitude joins north pole and south pole. If I draw here, all longitudes join north pole and south pole. And the middle one is 0 degree. Here I have drawn middle one is 0 degree. But it's a half circle, cannot divide our earth into two equal halves. But if I join them, them means just opposite of 0 degree, one more line we have, and that is 180 degree. So if we join them 0 and 180 degree, then we will get one full circle. And that full circle can divide our earth into two equal halves. So if it is 0, just opposite of 0, we have 180, which we cannot see now. That two lines together make a full circle and divides our earth into two equal halves. One half means your right side is called eastern hemisphere, left side is called western hemisphere. So two lines, two longitudes we are getting, except that in eastern hemisphere we have 179 longitudes, this side we have 179 longitudes. All together we have 360 degree longitudes. Okay, so these are the basic explanation, but you have to define them, that work I had given. And in case of definition, what you will say? The lines of longitudes are imaginary lines which join all the places having the same angular distance, east or west of prime meridian, like equator, like latitude, same thing. So this is our meridian. But here one thing is there, meridian. In short, I have written longitudes, but actual term is meridian. Even our one more topic was there, number 6, prime meridian. What is prime meridian? First we have to know what is meridian. Meridian means, if you take any one longitude, so we have 360. If you take one, any one, suppose you are taking this line, 1 degree east. So it moves from north to south, it joins north pole and south pole. So all places over this line, all, many places are there. And here, midday means 12 o'clock. Sun gives direct or vertical sun rays over here, so many places, try to understand, at the same time, that is 12 o'clock. Means if the time is 12 o'clock here, time over here is same, 12 o'clock. So that's why this longitude is called meridian. Meridian means the longitudes which join all the places having midday at the same time. That means meridian. Like that, we have one important meridian, that is 0 degree, called prime meridian. Prime meridian, why it is important? First of all, it is marked by 0 degree, and opposite of 0 degree, one more line I mentioned, 108. If we join them, we are getting full circle. And that line can divide our earth into two equal halves. That's why this line is very important. One more importance it has, to find or to locate standard time. That one I will discuss later. That's why prime meridian is very important. One importance, what I said, prime meridian and 180 degree lines together divide our earth into two equal halves. Another importance is this line help to find out standard time, and that is prime meridian, which is marked by 0 degree, located where? In London. One city is there called Greenwich near London. That's why this line is very important. Now, number 9, topic 9, I think it was geographic grid. See, latitudes we have seen has one importance to find out heat zone. Latitudes important to find out heat zone. Longitudes important to find out local time. Okay. And if we take these two lines, latitudes and longitude, means if we take all horizontal lines and all vertical lines together, they form geographic grid. It is another importance of these two lines, latitudes and longitudes together. Latitudes, again, I repeat, important to form heat zone. Longitude, important to find out local time. But all together helps geographic grid. So, I have drawn already. I think it is clear now that all horizontal lines and vertical lines, if we join, actually, they are distributed over the earth like this way. Okay. So, we are getting a small grid. Each grid is called geographic grid. And it has another importance. Wow. If we know the lat value and longitudinal value of any place, then easily we can locate that place on map. If we know that Africa is located, suppose I am giving one example. North and 31 degree east longitude. If you know these two value, lat and long, you can easily locate where is Africa on globe or map. So that is the importance of geographic grid. Geographic grid is a small box. It looks like a small box. It form with the help of latitude and longitude. But together help to locate any place on map or globe, if you know their value. That is geographic grid. Okay, now these topics are left. Topic 7, I didn't discuss clearly. So once again, I am telling now. And 10, 11, 12, 15, 16. You just follow that one. Topic 7, I think it was about local time. What is local time? Local time of a place recognized by midday sun. Again, I am telling. Local time of a place recognized by midday sun means, here I have drawn so many longitudes. Any number you can give. Any number. I am giving the number from 10 degree east. I am going towards right eastern. So 10, then 11, then 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It is coming 16 degree east. All are longitude. Longitudes important to find out the local time. So here local time means on 16 degree longitudes, and here local time not same. Because last day, previous class, I told you sunrise and sunset time varies because of the shape of earth. Same thing. So here sunrise time and here that time not same. That's why here midday, I told you local time is recognized by midday.
means when sun comes just above our head, that is at 12 o'clock. All of you know. Okay, that is 12 o'clock. So here all places, many places are here. A, B, C, D, E. So all places have the midday at the same time, and that is 12 o'clock. So that is the local time of these five places. So the local time of these five places and local time of these places X, Y, Z not same because of shape of the earth, you know. That's why we have to follow topic 10, that is standard time. It was your local time. So local time is clear. Local time means it is recognized by midday time when sun appears just above our head. And standard time, what is the standard time? Because local time varies, it is clear. Longitude to longitude it varies. Here one, here one, here one. That's why we need one standard time. Throughout the country we will follow that one, because I told India eastern part and western part time gap is 2 hours. So it will make confusion to create any timetable. That's why we follow standard time. Standard time means the time, local time. Standard time is a local time of central meridian. Means standard time is a local time. That means this line has one local time. But you see, it is the central one, middle one. So the local time of this middle latitude, longitude, central meridian taken as a standard time for whole country. Here local time, here local time, not same. Here to here, not same. Here to here, not same. So huge difference between last and this one, first. It will create confusion. That's why we follow the local time of middle longitude. Here the local time means when 12 o'clock will be appeared on this place, means place A will follow that same time, place X will follow same time. So standard time is a local time of a central meridian. That is standard time. Now IST, India has one standard time because of that same problem. Huge longitudinal extension. I told you our gap is 2 hours. So if you think, if it is 6 p.m. suppose, if it is 6 p.m. means evening, here what will be the time? 4 p.m. means sun is still appeared here. We can see the sunlight in this area, but we cannot see sunlight here. Huge gap, 2 hours gap. That's why you have to follow the standard time. So India has India's own standard time. That one in short is called IST, Indian Standard Time. And India standard time, yes, it's a local time of the standard meridian, central meridian. We have to know the central meridian's value. Indian central meridian's value, I think all of you know, 82 degree 30 minute east. It passes through Mirzapur near Allahabad in UP. It divides our country into almost two equal halves. That's why it is central. And the local time over this line we can take as a standard time of our whole country. That is called IST. And now number 12, that was Greenwich Mean Time. Yes. Indian standard time, we are following that one. But we have to follow the international standard time also to make the international timetable through aeroplanes. That's why GMT very important. GMT I have mentioned, prime meridian. Can you remember 0 degree line, prime meridian just opposite of this line, 180 degree, make full circle and divide our earth into two equal halves. And I told you prime meridian is very important to form standard time. And I told you that prime meridian is very important to form local time. That is the reason. So this line divides our earth together. These two lines together divides our earth into two equal halves. So the local time over this Greenwich line
form the standard time of whole world. That is called Greenwich Mean Time. Greenwich Mean because of the place name. I told you it is near London, Greenwich. So, the line which passes through that area, the local time on that line has taken as the standard time of whole world. That is called GMT. And the last part of our topic, number 15 and 16. That is completely different. I think local time and standard time, these two things, IST and GMT, these two things I cleared for you. Now, with the help of this timetable, we can find out the local time of any place. That one we can discuss later, I told you already. Now, the last part of today's topic, that is the Great Circle, and in a short I am writing Great Circle and the importance of Great Circle. What is Great Circle? Actually, equator is called Great Circle. Why? Because equator divides our earth into two equal halves. And the center part of equator and the center part of our earth coincide each other. That's why it is called Great Circle. Once again, I am telling why equator is called Great Circle. Because equator divides our earth into two equal halves. And the center part of equator and center part of our earth, they coincide. That's why this 0 degree line is marked as a Great Circle. We have many latitudes. You can ask me many latitudes we have. But they are not Great Circle because they don't divide our earth into two equal halves. That's why they are called Small Circle. They are called Small Circle. And this one is called Great Circle. Understood? And this circle has one importance. Navigators, aviators, they follow this route when they travel from one place to another because it saves time and fuel. That's why this line is very important. So now, today's chapter has completed. I am going to give you few more homeworks now. Friends, all topics which one I had mentioned already, I explained. Only one thing I left, one homework. I have given already 5 differences, only one actually I forgot. So here I have mentioned, you please write down differences between torrid zone and temperate zone. 4 already I think all of you have written. This is number 5. Okay. So this is our chapter. You read it nicely now and try to write all homework at home, which one will be checked definitely. Okay. Now, thank you. Have a nice day.